Hi friends, welcome to Tech Tutorial in Telugu by Teja. And in this video I am going to demonstrate how to create home directory or folder in Windows Server 2012 environment. And let us know first of all what is home directory. Home directory is nothing but home folder, which is also called as a network folder. It allows user to backup their files. Those files can be roam around any computer within the domain where user login. And I will explain you with an example. Okay, take the desktop one. If I create a home profile for user Teja with the drive letter, for example I'm taking as jet. Okay, when I create a user profile, if I create a home profile by assigning a drive letter jet, if I log into desktop one, when I log into desktop one, I can find this drive letter. A map drive will be assigned in our system. In our practical, like, we can see that with that, what's the advantage of this? So whatever the information belongs to the user Teja, I can save in the drive, in the jet drive, for examples like folders, files, whatever the important to me, I can save all the data in drive letter, drive in the drive jet. So I can log it off from desktop one. From the next day, if I come and sit in desktop 10, I find the same drive letter. So if I, in the next day, I came and sat at desktop 10, I have logged in as Teja. In the same way, I can find drive letter Z, and whatever the data I have saved, I can find it over here itself, just like a file server. So in file server, we can't save individual data, like whatever the user information data is there, we can't save that data. With this, by implementing the home folders, what we can do is we can save the user profile data by using this home directory. Okay, the administrator work will be less by, like, whomever the system admin or server admin is there, he can take the backup of all the users at a time. He will go to the shared folder and he will take the backup of it. I will explain in Telugu as well, friends. Home directories ante enti ante, like for example, nenu desktop one daggara kuchunanu, like with the username Teja. Ee home directory create chesamanla manu oka map directory map drive create avutundi computer desktop one lo. Teja tho nenu epudaithe login ayano oka map drive create avutundi. So aa map drive lo naaku sambandhinchina information anta save chesukuntanu. Next day, if I come and sit in desktop 10, for example, ఇది ఒక కస్టమర్ కేర్ అలాంటి సినారియోలో ఇది బాగా యూస్ అవుతుంది. డెస్క్టాప్ 10 లో కూర్చున్నాను. సో ఎప్పుడైతే నా ప్రొఫైల్ తో నేను లాగిన్ అవుతానో, ఈ జెట్ డ్రైవ్ అనేది కామన్ గా కనబడుతుంది. అప్పుడు నాకు సంబంధించిన డేటా మొత్తం ఈ కంప్యూటర్ నుంచి కూడా చూసుకోవచ్చు. దీనికి మనకి ఫైల్ సర్వర్స్, స్టోరేజెస్ అన్ని అలా చాలా ఉన్నాయి. లైక్ వాటిల్లో మనం ఒక ప్రాజెక్ట్కి సంబంధించిన ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్, లేకపోతే ఒక డిపార్ట్మెంట్కి సంబంధించిన ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ స్టోర్ చేయగలం. బట్ యూజర్కి సంబంధించిన ఫైల్స్, ఫోల్డర్స్, లైక్ సమ్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ డాక్యుమెంట్స్ ఉంటాయి వన్ యూఆర్ వర్కింగ్ ఫర్ కంపెనీ ఆర్ సంథింగ్. లైక్ ఒక యూజర్కి సంబంధించిన స్పెసిఫైడ్ డాక్యుమెంట్స్ అన్నీ లోకల్ సిస్టమ్లో కాకుండా ఇలా మ్యాప్ డ్రైవ్లో సేవ్ చేయడం వల్ల ఏమవుతుందంటే, ఎప్పుడైనా యూజర్ మానేసినా సరే, ఇన్ కేస్ కంపెనీ నుంచి వాకౌట్ అయిపోయినా, ఈ యూజర్కి సంబంధించిన కొన్ని ఇంపార్టెంట్ డాక్యుమెంట్స్ బ్యాకప్ కావాలి అంటే, అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటర్ తన వర్క్ చేసిన పీసీ దగ్గరికి వెళ్ళి తన డ్రైవ్ ఎక్కడ ఉందో అయితే డి డ్రైవ్ ఆర్ సి డ్రైవ్ అవన్నీ చూస్తే హెట్టిక్ వర్క్. సో ఫర్ దట్ పర్పస్ ఈ హోమ్ డైరెక్టరీస్ అంటే ఏంటంటే, అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటివ్ వర్క్ అనేది తక్కువైపోతుంది. సో ఎప్పుడైతే యూజర్ ఒక పర్సనల్, లైక్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ద యూజర్ ప్రొఫైల్ డేటా ఏదైతే కావాలనుకుంటున్నామో, అప్పుడు ఆ నెట్వర్క్ డ్రైవ్లోకి వెళ్ళి అందరి యూజర్స్ది ఒకేసారి బ్యాకప్ తీయవచ్చు. సో ద మెయిన్ అడ్వాంటేజ్, అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటర్ హూమ్ ఎవర్ ద సర్వర్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటర్ సిస్టమ్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటర్, దే కెన్ టేక్ బ్యాకప్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ద యూజర్ ప్రొఫైల్స్ డేటా ఎట్ అ టైమ్. ఓకే, అండ్ లెటస్ సీ హౌ టు క్రియేట్ దిస్ హోమ్ డైరెక్టరీస్ ఫర్ ఎ యూజర్. ఫర్ దిస్ వీ నీడ్ టు ఫాలో ఆల్ దిస్ స్టెప్స్. ఐ విల్ షో ఇన్ దిస్ వీడియో ఇన్ డీటెయిల్. అండ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ మై ల్యాబ్ సినారియో. అండ్ దిస్ ఈజ్ మై సర్వర్ యాక్టివ్ డైరెక్టరీ పీసీ. ఓకే, ద కంప్యూటర్ నేమ్ ఇస్ డీసీ, ద ఐపీ అడ్రస్ ఆఫ్ ఇట్ and the domain is ttt.com. The client is client 1, the computer name is client 1, the IP address is 13, and the client is added in a domain. Let us see now how to create a home directory. For this, first we need to create two users. For this, go to tools, go to Active Directory users and computers. See, now I will create two users for this practical. Okay, go to create, right click, click new, select user. I'm going to give username as Vani. Okay, Vani. Click next. So you can see I have created a user called Vani. I will create one more user, Rani. I'm taking small names for our convenience. Okay. See, I have created two users, Rani as well as Vani. Now I will create a group as well. Right click, new, select group over here. I will give a group name as home profile. See, home space profiles. See, the group has been created, home profiles. In this, I need to add the users whom I have created. Okay, for this we need to open the group, go to members, click add over here, and then you need to click advanced, and then you click find now over here. Now you can find whomever the users we have created. Select the Rani as well as go again find now and select Vani as well. Okay, I have selected both the users. Click OK. Now you can find the home profiles group contains two users, Rani and Vani. Apply and OK. Okay, and click close here. Now we need to create the shared folder for this. For this, I had only single drive, right? I'll open my C drive. See, for this, we need to create a new folder. I'm creating, right click, go to new, create folder. I'm going to create a folder name as home. After the creation of the folder, right click on the folder, go to properties, go to sharing, click on advanced sharing. So we need to check this box, and then you just add a dollar symbol. See, you need to add a dollar symbol behind this name, because for creating a hidden share we need to put dollar sign. Okay, and then you just click on permissions. You just remove everyone over here and then click on add, go to advanced, go to find. Now you can find a administrator over here. Add administrator and add our home, whatever the group we have created, home profiles. See, I have added admin as well as the home profiles. Click OK. And then you need to give permissions to read and change as well. For both, see, I have changed the permissions. I have assigned the permissions change as well as read, as well as the for group change as well as read. For permissions, we need to give in this way and click apply and click OK and then click OK. Let us see whether the folder has been shared successfully or not. For this, you must go to run command by pressing Windows plus R button and type cmd over there. Click enter. In this, you need to type net space share. See, whatever the shared folder has been shared, home, you can find it over here. See, the sharing has been completed. After the completion of this, click close, go to users and profiles, users and computers. And whomever the user we have created, Rani and Vani. Now go to Rani, right click, properties, go to profile. After going to the profile, you need to go to the home folders, click over here, connect, and we need to select which drive letter we are going to assign. Let us assign drive letter P for everyone. Okay. And in this two, we need to enter the shared path. How to enter the shared path? For this, you need to go to /dc/ whatever the folder name is, folder name along with the %, username, %. Why we have given %, username, %? Is it a system variable? So if we give in this such way, we need to give to the username in a manual way. So it will take automatically the username. Click apply and OK. Now go to properties and you can check it over here in the profile, the Rani. So system variable, if you give in such a way, the name will be assigned automatically and a folder will be created with this name whenever the user login. Okay. Do it same with the Vani as well. Go to properties, go to profile, assign drive letter P and share as I have specified. Okay. See, the sharing has been completed. Now let us log in with the client machine and check whether it is working or not. Okay, this is my client machine 1. See, this is my client machine 1. You can see the IP address 10.10.10.13. Now let us log in. Now I have logged in as Kim. I'll shut down it. I'll log off this one. And I will log in as the profile which we have created. I have created Vani with the name of Vani, right? For this, we need to go to Vani. So when we log into any desktop for the first time, it will show like this, preparing your desktop. Now let us see. See, you can find the drive letter P over here. It is empty actually. In this manner, you can find, see, it is a map drive. So let us create some folder. In Vani, I was creating some folder. Personal information of Vani. Just I have created and close this one. Let us log in with Vani as well. Rani, log off. See, I have logged in as Vani. Right now I will log in as Vani. Rani, okay. See, a map drive will be assigned to Rani as well. Now I will create some folder name. I have created a folder name as personal info of Rani. Now let us go to server and let us check whether whatever the folder I have saved, whether they are working fine or not. For this, you need to go to the folder where we have shared. See, there are two folder names with a Rani as well as a Vani. Go to Rani. See, the information whatever the user has been shared, it was saved over here. See, the main advantage of the home folders is administrator can take the backup of all the user profile information at a time. Okay. This is the main advantage. And thank you, friends. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you. Have a nice day.